Over here on this channel, we celebrate the small things. I don't give a freaking lacking if it was a freaking penny and I found it on head and it was heads up.
Only been a few hours, but it felt like days. Only been days, but it felt like months. Been gone for a year, only know like once. Life moves fast when you do what you want.
Hey you guys, this is our third freaking video. Welcome to my channel. Like, subscribe, share, do it all, because this is the channel that you want to be on. This is the one what you want to see. You want fashion, you want lifestyle, you want home, you want just everything and above, because I do not put myself in a box. This is it. So, I wanted to show you guys my outfit, so I'm going to go ahead and insert a clip here, because this outfit that I have on is from Family Dollar. I went to the store, and I saw, like, I was going there to grab a few things, and I saw this set, and I was like, I always wanted, like, a brown tan neutral set, Kim K, you know? And I'm like, ooh, but I never took the time to order and none of that. I don't know why, I just never did. So I actually walk in the store, cause you never see it in the store. I'm gonna be real, when I go to the store, I don't see the matching cute little tan sets every time I go to the store. So this was the very first time that I actually went to the store and saw a set, and it was freaking Family Dollar. So I was like, I'm gonna go and I'm a bag. I was like, I'm embarrassed. Oh, it's Family Dollar. But I said, you know what, Leah? We not embarrassed. Fashion is fashion. Clothes is clothes. And I, one thing about me, I know how to put a look together, honey. So I went ahead and bought the outfit. They had a black pair, too, set. And I wanted that. But I was like, Leah, you didn't even come here for that. You know, if I was on a budget. I'm like, but dang, it's Family Dollar. Why not get it? It was like literally $10 for the top. $10 for the bottom. So after this, I'm gonna show you guys a video. I'm gonna insert a video of me, the top and, you know, head to toe outfit, and also styling it, because yes, it's a Family Dollar look, but you know, I know how to make a look like it won't for Family Dollar, you hear me? So I definitely went ahead and put that look together, so I'm gonna insert that here.
Okay, so this is the look I was talking about. This is the two-piece set that I got from Family Dollar. But I want to show you guys how I style this two-piece set. Something that's very affordable and just make it, you know, a little more upscale. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, how I put this look together. It's just something cute that I decided to do because, I mean, yes, this is like plain Jane styling, but let's up it up a notch. So we're gonna go ahead and put on some accessories first. Let's go grab that. Here is some Louis Vuitton earrings that I'm going to put on to, you know, up the look. I feel like you should not leave the house without earrings, because, like, why? No matter what you got on, like, put on some earrings. Even if you wear, like, a bummy outfit, put on some earrings, and girl, you spiced up the look, okay? Next, we're gonna throw on a bag. This bag has gold detailing, gold with the gold earrings. This is a Coach bag that my mom gave me about 2 Christmases ago. I'm not really a Coach girly, but I do see the new cute bags they're coming up with, and I'm looking at them. So we'll see in the future if I ever get a bag. So this is something that you can wear outside, you know, quick. If it's like a sunny day, nice outside, X, Y, and Z. But hold on 1 second. I think I got some shades to go with this outfit. 1 second. All right, so I got some cute brown shades. Got them from, I don't remember. But you can put on some brown shades to go with the outfit. If it's a nice sunny day and you just want to look cute, go do some errands. This is definitely a cute look. You know how to upscale it. Again, this is from Family Dollar. But let's say it's a little sunny. It is sunny outside, but it's a little cold. You need to get a little fashionable coat. So you could throw on this trench coat. And I know it's not as dark as brown as these Michael Kors shoes right here. But it's definitely a look that you can just spice it up, as I stated. So we're gonna put this trench coat on. Fix it up a bit. And there we go, you guys. So here is the trench coat that you can make. It just upscaled the look just like that. The Louis Vuitton earrings, some shades that I probably got out the mall on the little strip thing they be having. This Coach bag, and then also my Michael Kors slides. So this is how I upscaled this look. For you guys, let's go ahead and get into the video. I just want to show you guys my outfit before we got started.
Now, talking about Family Dollar, I wanted to be clear. I wanted to make this video also about fashion and being affordable, because I see a lot of girls be trying to copy or be like the it girls that you see on YouTube, Instagram, or etc. You guys, their money, where they at in life, may not be where you are at in life. But I hope this show you, I hope this video show you that you can be fashionable on a budget. You can literally look like money, but be wearing an outfit for Family Dollar, okay? Look at me, I got these Louis Vuitton earrings, the most expensive thing I got on. Seriously. And then I got this $20 set. Like, come on, y'all. It's like, it's just all how you put it together. We all have to stop looking at how other people wearing, designing, and all that type of stuff. If you cannot afford that, don't go buy it. You can still look luxury and fabulous on a budget. So on this channel, I'm definitely going to show you guys how I make something very stylish. Make it look luxury, make it look like money, make it look just simple, stylish, period, on a budget. Over the weekend, I actually had attempted to go thrifting. Okay, y'all. So I went thrifting before. I lied. I never went thrifting before. I always wanted to go thrifting. My mom and dad used to go to the flea market like years ago, and I have no idea why, because when I was so excited and wanted to go, I just love shopping, period. Sorry, you guys, if you hear my dog in the background. He's having a time, but it's okay, babe. Babe, it's okay. Yeah, my man trying to calm him down. Like, it's okay, he's a dog. He's gonna do the most. But so I always wanted to go thrifting, and my parents went to like this huge flea market in Virginia, and I always used to go with them. I think I went like 2 or 3 times before, but my nose is shot. But however, I think I went like 2 or 3 times before with them. I'm gonna be real, I don't recall them ever walking out with none. I never recall them walking out with anything. So I think they were going for the, like, just to see things, like, because it's a huge place and seeing what people were selling. But I absolutely don't recall them walking out with anything. So I went because I love to shop and I love to see the different culture there. Like, you'll see people like that were Jamaican selling stuff that were from their culture. You'll see people that had actually painted something. Now, I was young with no money, so clearly I was a child. I didn't buy anything. I was just in there, just, I want, ooh, this is nice, this is nice. And, you know, I don't recall my mom and dad buying nothing for me. I don't even know why they went. but at the end of the day, I was like, you know what? When I get older, I'm gonna go thrifting. But I'm gonna be real. I've been to Marshall's. I've been to TJ Maxx. I do not like how it look in the inside. I be in there like, oh my goodness. Trying to get my life, trying to figure it out. Like, if I go in there, it has to be something particular. Like, I have to be going in there like, ooh, I want. So there's the TJ Maxx, they have like designer stuff in there. So I wanted to have this in there, or something for the home, like TJ Maxx home, if they got something like that in there. Like, stuff like that is when I would go in there. But other than that, if I can avoid it, I sure would. So I was like, dang, if I can't do Marshalls and TJ Maxx, how in the world am I going to go thrifting at freaking Goodwill and stuff? So, y'all, I went thrifting. I went, my hair itching. But I went to this Baltimore Baltimore, what was it called? Be More Thrift Place. I'm going to insert a screenshot of the place because it was like Be More Flea Market, something like that. It's beautiful. You guys, when I say it is beautiful in the inside, the first thing I thought as a fashionista, you could host a fashion show here. I will host a fashion show there. You guys, the architect, the art in the building is so freaking nice. It's so gorgeous. I'm actually going to insert some pictures and videos. So here's a cool couple that we met outside of the building, and the interior of the building was so stunning. This jacket was super cute but too small, but they also had a bedazzled jacket, but it was too high for me for some bedazzles. They had camo pants, shirts, jackets all over the place. This one I really, really liked but did not purchase. I kind of wish I did. They had tees and more. Now, what I did not expect is that they had a bar in there and music, but back to the video. Honestly, I was very much annoyed because, not because there was a lot of people in there, that was nothing, not because of me going through stuff, that was nothing, but I was kind of disappointed because I had my hopes up, y'all. I had my hopes up. I'm thinking, because when I think, thrift, I'm thinking vintage designer. Like, I wanted, like, I'm interested. I'm, like I said, I'm really getting into luxury and buying luxury and learning about luxury items. But so when I went in there, and the way how beautiful it looks in there, and the way I saw certain clothes and garments, I'm like, okay, they might got some luxury designer in there. I'm thinking I'm gonna find some vintage Dior, some Chanel. Like, I'm thinking I'm about to see some vintage design items. So I'm going through. I mean, I'm seeing vintage tees, which are very expensive. Did not know that. I actually seen it before, but kind of don't understand the background why they're so expensive. So I'm going to look into that. But vintage tees, you know, like worn or outfit, sweaters, whatever it was. And I understand that that's thrift, so you're going to wear items that were previously worn. I call them pre-loved items. I'm okay with that. I will buy a pre-loved bag in a heartbeat. But I think because I was so excited thinking I was going to see certain pieces, and I did not, I was very disappointed. I walked out like... But I'm glad I went because the environment and the people were nice. They had music up in there, drinks, beers, coffee. Like, they was like, have a good time. They were open. I think they started at like 11. It was very nice. Like, the environment was nice. But it was just disappointing because I, like I said, I wanted vintage designer, down to bed clothes, socks. I was interested in that stuff because I'm trying to build my collection for my closet. So I was very much disappointed. Will I go again? I will go for the vibe. And, you know, someone I know that's interested in thrifting and, you know, and they're in the area, that's the place that I would take them if they're open, because they're not just open every weekend. It's like they drop dates when they be like, all right, y'all, it's popping this week or it's popping next month. Like, it's not no, you can go every weekend to go to this. No, it's like you gotta be following them. You gotta know it's like a little low-key thing. So I did have high expectations, but that's my problem. I always have high expectations. But yeah, I would not go again unless, like, I bring a friend that's interested in thrifting and I know to refer her to that place. But yeah, other than that, I feel like overall, I'm not ashamed of where I shop at. If I find something that's like very, very nice, and if it's a thrift store, if it's a pre-loved bag or outfit from a website, if it's walking into Family Dollar. One thing about Leah Nicole, I know how to put a look together. I don't care if the shirt was a freaking $1 and the jeans was 15, baby. I know how to put the look together. I know how to make something look like nothing. I mean, make nothing look like something. And I will go to Family Dollar. If I walk to Family Dollar and they have another outfit, baby, Aaliyah, we be purchasing it. bringing it to the channel, putting it together for y'all, because don't be ashamed. Like, that was the whole thing of this, was just saying, like, live within your means. Don't be ashamed of you can't go buy that new Chanel bag. You can't go buy that new Louis Vuitton bag, or you can't wear these designer things that you see your faves, it girl or girls wearing that you follow. Like, who cares? They started from the bottom just like us. I'm starting from the bottom. I will buy things, like I said, if I can afford it, I will go ahead and buy it. But if I can't get it, I can't get it. Now, if something, now I do plan. So if there's something I'm really interested in, I know go with a look, I will plan, I will go buy it. But girls, if you make a certain salary, if you live in a certain life or a certain job, and it doesn't require you to be, you're not able actually to purchase these very lavish things you see on social media, who cares? Who cares? Who cares that you cannot get what the other girl got? Why you want to be the other girl in the first place? Be yourself. You was born to be you, and work hard to get to those things. But don't live through those other people, because you're gonna be struggling, lights off, no food in the refrigerator, trying to live like freaking Jada Waiter. Girl, she got money. Hey Jada. But yeah, like, you can't, you gotta live within your means, and you can still live within your means and be fashionable. But yeah, so I just want to talk about that a little bit. Another thing though, changing the subject, is probably something I should have started off with, to be honest. We got a celebration. So, I had a goal that I wanted to meet on my channel. It's not major. It's not like a huge number. But over here on this channel, we celebrate the small things. I don't give a freaking lacking if it was a freaking penny and I found it on head and it was heads up. We celebrate all the small things on my channel. So... overall, I want to say thank you guys. I have met my goal of 170 subscribers. I'm so excited. First of all, if I'm sounding clear, because I don't got my Vitalines in. I'm on another tray, by the way. But anywho, I'm so excited. I actually have my glass of wine sitting right here. And I'm going to go ahead and take a sip for y'all, okay? This wine is so good. I already poured it up, y'all. Don't judge me. And drunk a little bit. But the wine I'm drinking is Linganore Wine Cellar, Mountain White Sweet White Wine. Boy, when I say this wine is so good, you guys, it's sweet. I do not like tart, tangy, dry wine. That's not me. I like sweet wine. If it's not sweet, don't hand it to me, baby. I went to a winery with an old friend that she invited me to go to a winery, and it was my very first time. And when I went, I was trying their wine, of course, and everything I tried was delicioso. It was so good, guys. It was so good. They have a strawberry one. I don't have that right now. But this is the one I actually have a big bottle, I think, of this one, y'all. Like, it's big. But this is like $14.99 at a liquor store near me. Do not, if you're under the age of 21, no. This ain't for you. You can save it as your favorites and wait till you're 21 to drink it. But Aaliyah and Nicole, we do not on this channel encourage underage drinking. But I do encourage celebrating small things. And we are celebrating that we have surpassed our goal, actually, because the goal was 170. And I think I'm at 172 as of Sunday or Saturday, however, last week. And I was like, I don't want to celebrate because it might be a robot. It can go back. And then I said, okay, I said Sunday went past. I was like, oh, I really hit my goal. So on this channel, we celebrating the smart goals. And I'm very much excited about that because I had a downfall where I had got ill and I wasn't able to make any videos. And I was getting, you know, I was getting up there. But then, you know, I had to take a huge pause and, you know, I'm taking my health very seriously. And I'm just glad that me coming back the way I did, especially when you stop being consistent, me coming back the way I did, I'm able to come back and then I met my goals when I got back. Could have met it months ago, but everything happened for a reason and I got some real genuine supporters. So thank you guys for joining my channel. Thank you guys for subscribing, liking, and sharing, commenting. Thank you guys so much. All 172. Yes. Turn up. And you want to know how we go celebrate? Not just with wine, but also with my Valentino. We're going to do a luxury unboxing as well. So this is a gift to myself. Y'all probably like, girl, you just made an excuse to buy some. Yup. Thank y'all. I went ahead and did this. So we're going to also do a luxury unboxing today of this Valentino Donna Born in Roma Intense Perfume. So today I was very much waiting to open this for you guys. I can't wait. This is hard to find in store. Now if you want to order offline, okay, great. But I'm a type of girl, I want to smell it right then and there and then buy it. I am getting into my fragrances. I'm trying to build my collection, my luxury collection, as you can see. I'm trying to build my collection. I have other perfumes that if you guys want to see them. But this is my second purchase. Well, not my second. But this is another purchase that I got. And we're going to open it today. So exciting. So we're going to go ahead and open this. Smell it and I'll let you guys know what it's about. Now I'm gonna be real, most of the girls already got this. I don't remember how much this costs. Alex, you remember how much this costs? You remember how much this costs? So we're gonna guess that it was about probably $140. You looking it up? He's looking it up right now. In the meantime, it was over $100. So if you're looking, and I think this is 1.7 ounces for $100. So we're going to take a look at the bottle, the detailing of this bottle, go over it, and also let you know what it smells like. Now, I am not a pro at this, so I'm not going to give, it gives vanilla, it gives straw, it gives soft, no. I'm just a beginner. I'm going to say, ooh, this smells good. Or, ooh, nah, I'm not buying again. And if I do smell something that smells familiar, then I'll say that. But I don't want you guys thinking this is a perfume. I don't want you guys thinking this is a perfume channel where I talk about perfume, giving it very detailed. Now, as I get more into perfumes and learning more about the senses and what's in this and details of the perfume, then I'd be welcome to disclose that. But in the meantime, I'm also a beginner with buying this. So this is basically going over beginner luxury perfume that I recently purchased because we're celebrating the 172 subscribers and, you know, and also, you know, fabulously doing it. So let's go ahead and open this. Can you find a price? So it comes plastic wrapped. We're gonna take this wrap off. If I could. Okay, there we go. Ooh. Is it me or this box? Oh, this, okay. So it got like detailing, diamond. You can rub on here. I like how they do that. Their box isn't just a plain box. It's embroidered diamond detailing on the box. Very smooth. I like it. Soon I touched, like when I say y'all pay attention to everything, soon I touched this box. It was given what it needed to give. So now what's in here? There's a lot of small words that I'm not reading. But yes, so this is the box. I might keep the box just because how it feels. And my favorite color is pink, so I might use this for the closet. We'll see. 140. Round the nose, y'all. This was 140 for a 1.7 ounce bottle. So in the inside, soon you open, it's some words here. Oh, it's a code for special rewards on Valentino. Then I know that. I get mine from Macy's, so I like to walk in there and buy whatever I want. So we're going to go ahead and open this box. Whoop. There it is. Whoop, whoop. There it is. It's so cute, you guys. I'm sorry. I'm looking at something else at the same time, y'all. But this is so cute. Oh, my goodness. And then the same, it's another thing, the same embroidered design that's on this bottle is also all, I mean, on the box, it's also on the bottle. Like, they definitely, very, very, they definitely pay attention to details. They were not playing. I like that they match their Valentino stud. So that made me think of how they do their purses. So if you know Valentino or you're familiar with the purses, they have these studs, these diamond studs. Diamond shaped square, however, studs they have just like this on their purses, on their handbags. I think I have a picture of a handbag that I really, 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 really want. I think if I do, I'll insert it. If not, then clearly I don't, and we're just gonna let it go. But however, yes. And it's like, I wanted the big one. I wanted the bigger one. But when I say every time I go in there, you guys, it was sold out. So one, even the small one. So we went all the way to, I think, Townsend one day. Not all the way. It's like 20 some minutes. But we went there and I got lucky and was able to get the small one. Best believe I'm going to get the bigger one. I don't care that I have the small one. I want the bigger one too. Because honestly, when I buy perfume, I buy the largest ounce. I don't get the smallest one. I get the smallest one if it's like, if I have no choice with this. So it's cute. It's small. It's definitely something that you could put in your handbag, depending on the bag. Personally, I wouldn't travel with anything like this. I'm just touching it because it's like glass, almost fiber glass or whatever. So personally, I would not travel with this. If they have like a travel one, of course get that. But it is small. I carry a big bag, so this can just, I can really put this in there if I want to. But yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and take this off. I see the detailing even of the, can y'all see that? Oh my goodness. The detailing of even the rim of the cap. Valentino, I love that for you guys. So let's take this off. Hopefully I take it off right. Shoot. Oh, it just popped right on off. So I'm trying to see if the spray is this. I'm gonna go ahead and spray this on. I'm a little nervous, y'all, because one, this bottle is expensive, and I don't remember how it smelled, but it had to smell good because there's no way I would buy something. And it don't smell good. So let's go ahead and spray. So this is what I learned how to spray your perfume. So typically I have an oil on my wrist where I want to spray it, and I just spray it. You don't rub it in, you guys. You let it sit there. Air it out, and you let it sit there. So let's go ahead and spray. I don't want to miss my wrist. Oh my goodness, y'all. Oh my goodness. My man gonna eat me alive. Y'all, okay, so we're gonna wave it a little bit. If you don't got it, go get it. If you don't got, if you run and go get it now. Okay, so it does have like a floral, fruity floral. I like that. It's mixed powder, almost, yeah, like fruity floral. It's like a fruity floral powder all mixed together. Hint of vanilla. I feel like, I don't smell of vanilla. I don't know. definitely powdery. Oh yeah. So if you want, like, go. Honestly, what I might start doing is ask when I go in there and smell the perfume, ask them, like, what's this, you know, what details of this perfume, what it consists of. So then I'll be able to share with you guys and I become knowledgeable as well. But y'all, okay, I'm about to, girl, forget this. I know. Yes. Okay, we ain't gonna spray the bowl. Y'all, this is why I need the big bottle. This is just 1.7 ounces. I'm getting the big bottle ASAP. I'm gonna have to get that. Valentine's Day, y'all. Get it. This is perfect to wear on Valentine's Day, y'all. Oh my goodness, on a date. Girl, don't get pregnant now. But wrap it up. Because this right here, walk past a man. Oh my goodness. And the girl's been trying to tell me about this, but I'd be like, I'm not gonna get it because everybody and their mama got it. Cause look, I had went to Macy's. I tried a perfume that everybody and their mama was talking about. I smelled that. I was like, now y'all tripping. Y'all just liking stuff because everybody like it. And that's not me. So I went and had to do it, found some other perfumes. Now this one I did see on Instagram scrolling when a young lady was actually talking about perfumes and stuff and like a list of them showing. And I was like, okay, I take heed to that. Wrote it down, went to Macy's, tried. I was like, this is good. So, but I realized when I buy perfume, what my issue was with perfume and why it wasn't lasting for me and why I started looking more in luxury is because I wasn't buying what go with my body oils, like my body. I realized like I was buying stuff because it just smelled good, but mixed with my body chemicals or whatever, I said chemicals, oh my goodness, with my body oils and stuff, it was not, it wasn't lasting. It was just sinking, like just seeping through like my skin, and it wasn't lasting. So I went and talked to like a professional person that sells perfume, and she was like, okay, you need stronger. And I was like, oh, I don't like strong perfumes. Like, I don't want to smell like grandma. But she showed me certain perfumes or certain brands. Like you have the toilette perfume, you have elixir. And this one actually, I think this one is, I forgot one. You also have Intense. So I need Intense perfume because it's stronger and it lasts. So that is what I needed for my body chemistry. That's the word I was looking for, body chemistry, that works with me and that lasts. So don't just go to the store and buy perfume because you see one girl got it. And you're like, OMG, or you smell it and it smells good. Actually, talk to the sales representative and that's selling the perfume or however. Talk to them and let them know what you look for, but also let them know you want something that lasts. And, you know, explain to them what's been going on when you put perfume on. And they will guide you literally to detail and say, okay, you need something with a little bit of jasmine. Or you need something that's more intense. Like they will tell you what you need in your perfume so it can last on your body. And your body chemistry, we all got different body chemistries. We be sitting right here thinking like, oh, we all can do it. No. So I was getting pissed off. I was like, why I'm paying all this money for this perfume and it's not lasting. So I literally had to find a perfume that goes with my body chemistry. And this is one of them. And specifically the Intense one. I have to get the Intense one. It will last on me. It will smell beautiful. And my man loves it. A long time ago, Aaliyah would not get this. Because I don't like floral giving me Japanese flower. Like, is that what it's called? I don't know. But I never liked the floral type. I never thought I did. But I guess certain stuff needs to be mixed with it for me to like it. So when she went over this one and she sprayed it, I was like, hold on. It still got flowers. Definitely giving me powder, flower, smell or whatnot, but it also is sweet. And that whatever it is all mixed with made my day. And I was so happy to spend my little $140 on this, and I want the bigger bottle. So I definitely recommend, but before you purchase, speak with someone first and, you know, see if it works with your body chemistry. And you guys, that is it. So we did a lot in this video. We did a luxury unboxing perfume, styling my affordable outfit and making it lavishly fine, and celebrating you guys. So that is it. I am out, and thank you guys for watching. And thank God and you guys for watching. I appreciate you guys, and I hope you enjoy the video. See y'all next time. Oh, I also want to apologize on the late upload. Typically, we are Sunday. Sunday, we post every week on Sunday, but it may be days where I have to post the following day or however, and weekend could get hectic. Sundays is football, so I'm still going to try to keep that day. And if anything changes, I will let you guys know. But again, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you guys. Like, share, comment, blow it up. Let me know how I'm doing. Let me know how you feeling. And I appreciate you guys. And you guys have a good night. Bye.